Hello, friends, and welcome back to r/ProRevenge. In the first story, we'll talk about how the OP got out of a situation where he wasn't paid for being a few minutes late to work. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you're new here and turn on notifications so you don't miss a new video every single day. Here we go. Dock pay for being late by 2 minutes? Enjoy paying massive overtime. I worked in an electricity retailer call center. It was highly unionized, but the management tracked login times to the minute. One incredibly ridiculous thing they did is if you were a minute or two late, they would literally dock your pay by that many minutes. It wasn't really enough for us to really notice, and I'm sure they didn't actually save any money. I mean, if you were 15 minutes late, I could understand not paying, but 3 minutes late? Well, eventually the union discovered what they were doing and were completely PO'd that they hadn't been consulted about this D move. The union demanded log on and log off times for everyone in the call center. What management hadn't counted on was that all of us would often need to wrap up calls and clear the call queue before the call center could officially close. This often meant that operators would leave several minutes after their shift. On bad occasions, it could be 15 to 20 minutes delay before they could clock off. But mostly it was only a few minutes. The union made management recalculate everyone's pay for the year based on clock on and clock off time. They also pointed out that staying past end of shift triggered penalty rates. It turns out everyone, and I mean everyone, had spent more time wrapping up calls at the end of the day than they were late clocking in. Each of us got paid for lost wages at overtime rates. It cost them a fortune, and they never docked the pay of anyone who was late ever again. And our last story. Crazy lady lit my buddy's land on fire, so he burned down her world. I was visiting a friend who owns and operates a trailer park. Basically, his house is the main office. A couple had just moved into the lot with their mobile home. The dude seemed fine, and him and his girlfriend had just had their first kid. Well, at 3 a.m., just a few hours after I arrived, the boyfriend showed up at my friend's house, the main office. Apparently, he had a DNA test done, and he found out the kid wasn't his. So while the girlfriend was still in the hospital, he started effing around on her to get back at her. Well, earlier that day, she got released from the hospital, and he refused to go pick her up. So she walked from the hospital to the trailer park, easily 20 miles, and found him sleeping with this girl. She went ape crap. She started trashing their tiny mobile home while he and his mistress quickly got their clothes on, and the boyfriend opted to drive the mistress back to her place. When he got back, his soon-to-be ex-girlfriend locked him out of their mobile home. So at 3 a.m., he showed up at the front office to call the police. My buddy woke me up, filled me in on the situation, and I went out to his living room to keep the dude company. I explained that if the kid isn't his and he signed the birth certificate, he has 60 days to remove himself from the birth certificate. Otherwise, he'll be on the hook for child support. I also explained that while calling the cops is a good idea, they likely won't be able to remove her from the mobile home since she had established residency. Well, the cops showed up, knocked on the door, and she answered. The cops just did a welfare check on the kid. They left, and he was allowed back into the mobile home by his soon-to-be ex. It would have been nice if that were the end. Nope, not even close. Not even 30 minutes after the cops left, the dude came back up to the main office and said he needed to call the cops again. She stole his car. From what he said, she even tried to run him over before she sped off into the night. Before the cops could get back to the park, she came back and she started doing donuts in my buddy's yard. She ran over his garden and just effed up his yard in general. She finally stopped about a minute before the police arrived. The cops got out of their cruisers and arrested this chick on the spot. The charge? Misdemeanor malicious mischief. They charged her for ruining my buddy's garden, and that was it. A day passed and crazy lady got released on bond. She came back to their mobile home and got right back into it with her soon-to-be ex. During the fight, she started scratching at her throat until she had left a lasting mark. She called the cops, claimed he laid hands on her, and the cops came and arrested him for domestic violence. The cops took the kid and placed him in protective custody. As an aside, I know that she fabricated the "he beat me" story because she bragged about it after the cops left. She even went so far as to call the dude's parents and brag about getting their son locked up. Now my buddy is freaking out. He's got a crazy lady on his property. Crazy lady has no income, and she just had their only source of income locked up and subsequently fired for being locked up. There's no way in hell they're going to pay rent anytime soon. He wants her gone, but legally he has no recourse because they aren't past due on rent. Another day passed, homie was still locked up, and crazy lady had started throwing all their belongings into the yard of their lot and partially onto my buddy's property. My buddy told her she needed to clean up her yard by 6 p.m. or he would write up a violation. She ignored him. An hour or so after that, I was helping my buddy move some stacks of bricks in his backyard, which was right next to the lot her boyfriend had rented, and the entire time she was just talking to herself. She wasn't talking to herself in a normal way. No, she was yelling random crap like, minimum wage, and they fired me, and $10.75 an hour, and they fired me, $35K a year, and they fired me, mother effers, or I just want to enjoy my life in peace, but they won't effing let me, I'll kill them. We decided it would be best not to acknowledge her at all. We stopped working and went back inside for some lunch. Then we saw the smoke. That crazy bee set fire to a pile of papers on my buddy's property, not even on her own lot. My buddy called the cops, who arrived in record time along with the fire department. They arrived to find her with a lighter and a can of gasoline in her hands. She had the water running and tried to go turn it off, but the cops stopped her. My buddy opted to turn the water off for her, so he went in and turned the water off to her mobile home. She screamed her head off at my buddy for doing that, despite the cops telling him to go ahead and do it. The fire department put out the fire, and the cops put handcuffs on her and stuffed her into the cruiser. I thought to myself, finally, this crazy bee is getting put away for arson. Nope. The fire marshal refused to come investigate, so it couldn't be classified as arson. The cops wrote her a citation and released her. My buddy told the cops he wanted to press charges for trespassing as she had started the fire on his property. The cops advised that they couldn't because they would need to show intent. She needed to know she was trespassing, in other words. Since there wasn't a clear marker indicating that she was, the cops couldn't arrest her for it. So my buddy told the cops where his property started and asked if the cop would explain that to her so that when she inevitably does trespass again, they'll be able to arrest her. The cop agreed. He explained where her property ended and that she was under no circumstances to set foot on my buddy's land. As the cops were leaving, she looked at me and my buddy and said, "You're lucky I don't bash your heads in with my baseball bat." Followed quickly by, "I'm gonna blow your effing heads off, mother effers." The cops had their windows rolled down, but they did nothing. They just left. An hour passed and we see Crazy Bee standing in the middle of the street, stopping every car that passed. Finally, one of them pulled into the park, parked on my buddy's property, and let her use their cell to call the cops. Why was she calling the cops? She tried to get them to come arrest my buddy for turning her water off for her on police orders. Since she was standing on my buddy's property to call the cops, he whipped out his phone and recorded her standing on his property. Then he called the cops himself. When the cops came, she was certainly surprised when they put her in handcuffs immediately. The cop who had responded before, the one who explained to her where her land ended, came over, watched the video my buddy recorded on his cell, and then he explained that he would not be arresting her for trespassing. He was going to do an emergency order of detention. Basically, she was going to be forcibly taken to the closest hospital where she would be evaluated briefly and then released. He explained that she would be back out before the day was done. My buddy didn't bother insisting that he wanted to press charges for trespassing. I wondered why, but after the cops left, he called her ex-boyfriend's parents who, as luck would have it, had the only key to the mobile home. It was given to them by police as it was on their son when he was arrested for domestic violence. They came out and they locked up the RV. My buddy then noticed a water leak coming from the valve, so he turned off the water to the entire park, briefly, cut off the section of pipe attached to the valve, and capped it off to stop the leak. Lastly, remember how he warned the crazy lady to clean up her yard or she'd get a violation? Well, she never cleaned up her yard. Instead, she just threw about everything that was in the RV into the yard. Well, as it's written in the rental agreement, my buddy cleaned her yard. He took everything that was out in the yard, TV, mattress, microwave, etc., and hauled it off to the dump. Then he wrote out a violation as well as a bill for having to clean her yard. Well, crazy lady got out a few hours after she was taken in, and she called her ex-boyfriend's parents to try getting a ride. They promptly hung up on her, and they immediately called us. We had plans to grill out for dinner, and my buddy invited them over for dinner and a show. She arrived after the sun had set, and well after we'd eaten. We were sitting out on my buddy's patio, which had a very clear view of the mobile home, when the crazy lady saw us. She let us know how she really felt. She called us every name in the book. She hadn't gotten to the mobile home yet, and because it was dark, she couldn't even see that her yard had been cleaned. We sat there and took every name she could dish out, and we collectively laughed as we all knew what was about to happen. After she realized we were laughing at her, she hit us with a final F you before storming off to the mobile home. As she got closer, she could see that her yard was barren. When she got to the door, she could see the notice attached. When she went to turn the door handle, it wouldn't budge. After a few moments of silence, it finally clicked in her head. She screamed out to the night, "Mother effers!" She must have been thirsty after her long walk because she went to the water hose only to find that it wasn't on. Then she went to turn on the water only to find that it had been capped off, no valve in sight. My buddy yelled out to her, "Sorry, there was a water leak at the valve. It was park property, so I capped it off. I'll have it repaired within the next 2 weeks, though." Coincidentally, 2 weeks was the earliest time he could start the eviction process. Hey guys, thank you all for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one.